PetesTools.com.
G'day guys, here we are going today, another boring episode of Pete's Tools for you. Hey, I've been playing with these things lately, guys. I brought some of these and I thought I'd have a go at playing some of these, see if I could do some arc gouging or whatever the hell you call it. But I haven't really got anything to run it with, so I thought I'd see if I could get these things to work on my MiG welder. Can you use your MiG welder to run these arc gouging things? Let's give it a crack! Yeehaw! Anyway guys, same as usual, like my video, subscribe, drop me a like, drop me a comment. Come say g'day at Pete's Tools if you want. Come say g'day in the comments below, and we can have a bit of a yarn. Anyway guys, let's get into it. So guys, you reckon I can get one of these to run with this machine here? Why not? Let's give it a crack. Yeehaw! So the first thing we have to do, guys, is I'm going to turn the speed of the wire right down. See, we've got that turned off. Basically, guys, what we don't want is the wire to start feeding through my MIG machine. All I'm basically trying to do is use the MIG welder as a power pack to see if we can get those carbon rods to ignite, basically. So even though I've turned the speed of the wire right off, it still moves a fraction. See that, guys? So what I'll do now is just flick this off so we don't have any drive in here, so there's no way in hell it can push the wire through my machine. See that? It's still turning. You can see it's still turning here, but it's doing absolutely nothing to the wire, so that's what we want. Yeehaw! So what I've done, guys, is I've turned the welder off until I can get a bit of wire wrapped around the trigger here. There's a wire or a zip tie or something. I just ran out of zip ties. I normally use zip ties, but I use a hunk of wire that I've got lying around the workshop floor. And it just broke like that. Flux core wire, man, it's soft. Let's try something else. Right, guys, better luck this time. I've got a bit of solid core wire. It's normally a bit stronger, eh, than the old flux core. That's why people have trouble jamming up their machines, I think, with flux core, because it's so deadly soft. Anyway, enough waffle, Pete. Let's get on with this. So what I reckon we should do, guys, is just, like, get a pair of vice grips and just vice grips and just vice grip the contact tip on your MIG torch to whatever you're going to try and gouge. So just grab your contact tip and just lock it up. So we've got a earth on there. Yep, looking good, looking good. Right, so we've got our earth here. So what I'm going to do with my earth, guys, is use this to hold the electrode, the carbon rod, and we'll see how we go. Yeehaw! So remember, guys, if you're going to do this, if you've got your torch vice clamped down like this, never leave your earth lead on here, because the earth lead becomes the electrode for whatever you're doing. So if you leave that on there and then go and turn your machine on, the whole lot's just going to blow the fuses and stuff. And I've done that once or twice before. Anyway, we'll use this as my electrode holder and we'll put our carbon rod in and see if we can actually make some sparks. Yeah! Alright, let's give it a crack, Nigel. I've got a bit of a weld here that I could probably have a go at getting rid of. Let's have a look. Oh, shit. Well, something worked. Holy crap, that looks like it's going to work. Put your eye protection on, Pete. Can't bloody see. Well, hell. Whew, see that, guys? Might zoom in a bit and have a look a bit better, eh? Right, now, guys, got it a bit closer up for you. Let's see how it goes. I've got my MIG welder on about half power setting, so we're on about 125 amps. Burning a hole in it, guys. Yee-haw! Cool, cool bananas, but what we need is to blow that malt away. I know what I'll do. Hey, I'll go and grab the air gun from a compressor and I'll blow some air on it while we're doing it. Yeah!
Right, guys, I've got my air gun. I've got my carbon rod here. Let's see what happens. Awesome. Now, guys, let's see how we go. Put some air onto it. the air really seems to cool it off. There we go. The air definitely blows the molt away, guys.
So the air definitely does make a bit of a difference, guys, but I found that the more air that I push onto it, the cooler this gets, and it just doesn't seem to run. Mind you, I could always turn up my MiG welder a little bit, I suppose, to get a bit more grunt out of it. Like I say, I think we're only running about 125 amps. Anyway, guys, that was my play for the day. It was quite interesting, I thought. I like playing with these carbon rods. They're quite cool. I might see if I can do some other videos and some other bits and pieces on what to do with them. And anyway, guys, same as usual. If you like my video, subscribe, drop me a like, drop me a comment. Come say good day in the comments below. And we'll see you next time, eh? Bye.
PeteTools.com.